Friends, welcome to Center for Online Education. Today, in the series of production management, we are going to discuss a very vital and important topic that is known as the capacity planning. As in the series of production management, we are seeing that as a production manager, what a person has to do and from where his managerial decisions can be enhanced for the betterment of the organization. So today we are exploring another topic that is known as the capacity planning. Now let's see that what is capacity. A dictionary meaning of the capacity is the ability to hold, receive, store or accommodate. Means the capacity of a person to hold, accommodate, store or to receive the things. The more the person has got this ability, the more capacity he or she holds. Then the capacity is also defined as the maximum output of a system in a given period of time under idle conditions. Idle conditions means the conditions in which the service or the work is to be performed. And here the maximum output which can be taken out by a system or a process so that the minimum wastage and the maximum utilization of the work can be done. Now, management of capacity basically involves capacity planning, balance between various issues against economic advantages and disadvantages, and the proper utilization. Means economics is all about demand and supply. So here as a production manager, one has to see that what are the decisions which are going to be beneficial for the organization and what are the decisions which is going to affect or harm the organization in the future run. So as a manager, you have to avoid that decisions and take the decisions for the betterment and for the advantages of any organization. So here capacity is all about involved in the balancing and the planning of a system. Now we see that what is the meaning of a capacity location. So capacity refers to a system potential for producing goods or delivering services over a specified interval time. Specified interval of time means that on a given time, means from the starting of a process to the end of the process, and the potential of any firm to produce goods or services. For example, if you are producing a pen, so what are the raw material you are required, at what time this raw material is being processed, and the final layout of the pen, means the product of the pen is going to come in the market. So this is all about the capacity of a specific unit, that how much quantity of pens the unit is going to manufacturing in a specified period of time. Now key inputs to capacity planning, that what are the inputs which is being required for a capacity planning. A manager should hold these things. The first one is the kind of capacity that will be needed. Means what type of capability, whether it is a process capability, means in the process what you required, whether it is a raw material capabilities, means what are the raw materials we are going to get, whether it is a labor capacity or manpower capacity, means what is skills or the resources which is being required by a specific person to perform that specific duty. How much capacity will be needed? How much these things are being required? If you are dealing with the manpower, how many people are going to require? If you are dealing with the process, what is the process and what is the time which is being required for each process to be completed? If it is all about the plant, you have to deal with what type of plant and what type of locations is going to be there. So here, how much capacity means it is being divided into specific numbers. When will it be needed? Means at what time it will be needed? If you are dealing with human resources, you know that in human resources, right man, right place, right time and right cost. So what are the skill a person is holding and where this person is been working the specific process. So you have got a specific process A, B, C, D. So for performing all these four functions, you require certain specific human resource who are being skilled in all this A, B, C, D process. So here, at what time when you are performing the A function, you are requiring the person with the capabilities of A, B, you are requiring a person who are having a capabilities to perform the activity B. If
C is being happening, you have to require with the person having a specific qualities of perform the function of C. Same way in the D. So all this process is being done or being performed by persons who have got specific skills, and these specific skills are being required to perform that specific functions. So here, when it will be needed, so it being function over there. For example, if we take an example of a cricket team, you can see over here the capacity that will be needed means you have to make a team of 11 persons. You require batsmen, you require fielders, you require a wicketkeeper, and you require a bowler. So this is the capacity which is being needed. How much batsman you required, how one wicketkeeper you required, and a bowler required. What capacity is needed? Means when you are talking about the batsman, there is opener, there is a middleman. So all these things are being. If you are talking about bowler, you are going to say that there will be a fast bowler, there will be a spinner. So you have to take it over here. And when it will be needed means whether if you are going to win the toss, you require batsman to come over there. If you are going to lose the toss, you are going to get the bowler over there. So the time is also being required, that at what specific time you are requiring the specific skill of a person. Now moving ahead, capacity planning classification. We can classify the capacity planning into three terms, that is known as the long-term capacity planning, medium-term capacity planning, and short-term capacity planning. If you are talking about the long-term capacity planning, we are going to explore that long-range capacity of an organization is dependent on various other capacities like design capacity, production capacity, sustainable capacity, and effective capacity. Means here there are four types of capacity which is being required in the long-term capacity form. Long-term capacity means that whenever an organization or a production unit is talking about or thinking about or planning about of more than 5 years to 10 years, we are saying that it is a long-term planning process. So here, design capacity is the maximum output possible as indicated by the equipment manufacturer under idle working condition. When we are talking about design capacity, we are talking about the design of a system. When we are talking about the production capacity, at what time or how many units can be produced by a specific unit. If we are talking about the sustainable capacity, means we are talking about at what time the product is going to sustain in the market or the people who are using over there. And effective capacity means that taking the customer into action and what is the impact of that product on the customer that you are going to buy the product time and again. So here this is all about the long-term capacity. When we talk about the medium-term capacity, the strategic capacity planning undertaken by organization for 2 to 3 years of a time frame is referred to as medium-term capacity planning. Same way, if you're talking about taking a time frame of 2 to 3 years, we are saying that we are talking about the medium-term capacity planning. Here also, all the four concepts, that is design, productivity, effectivity, every planning should be considered as we are talking about in the long-term capacity planning. Now, short-term capacity planning. The strategic planning undertaken by organization for a daily, weekly, or quarterly time frame is referred to as a short-term capacity planning. Here you can say that we are talking about the daily, weekly, or quarterly time frame. Means we are taking 4 months in a consideration. We are talking about each and every day. We are talking about the weeks. We have got a year and we are dividing into 52 or 53 weeks. We are saying that we are dealing and planning for each and specific week or each and specific month or 4 monthly, quarterly. So all this planning which is done comes into the area of short-term capacity planning. Now, what are the goals of capacity planning? Whenever we used to perform any action, there is a reaction. So what goals we have to achieve by the help of capacity planning? The first one is lead capacity planning. You all know that there is a time frame of certain activity to be completed, means the activity is going to start and it is going to be completed into a specific time. So from the time it has started and the finish time at which it is going to be completed is known as the lead capacity planning time. So it is very important for a production manager to know about this. Then you have got lag strategy planning. Means there are certain time frame between the two lead process to be occurring. Means in the lead capacity we have talked about starting of a process and of an end of a process. Now after the end of the specific project, you have to start another project. So here, that lag, the time between the two projects to be completed, from the first project to second project, we say that it is a lag strategy planning. Then you have got the third one, that is a match strategy planning. It is the combination or balance between the two things that we say that at this specific time, we are closing this project and we are starting this project from this day. So the distance between them is going to be very minimal. Now, factors affecting capacity planning. There are various factors which affect the capacity planning. The first one is the production facility. As you all know that in the past lecture, I have told you that production is all about the layout, design, and the location where the organization has set to produce a specific product. So production facility is very important for a capacity location. The second one is product line or matrix. The product, whether you are making a product in a line system or you are having a matrix system for producing a product. So it is very important. Then production technology, what type of technology you are using to manufacture a specific project. And human capital, again the job design, compensation system, the recruitment system, the training and development you are going to do, the appraisal system, the job satisfaction system, all comes over here. These are the factors which highly affect upon the capacity location. Then you have got operational structure, scheduling, quality assurance, you have got supply chain management system. So all the operational structure used to come over here. Then external structure. Organization is always being affected by the government policies. Organization is always being affected by the taxing system. So here policy of the government and safety regulations are very important as these are the external factors but has a direct impact on the production of any product. Now, what are the steps in the capacity planning? How you are going to plan that we are going to allocate and specify our capacity? First is estimate future capacity requirement. If today you are producing 1000 units of certain product and you require to increase the production by 500 units. So here the first one is to estimate the future requirement. The second one is evaluate existing capacity. Means we have evaluated that presently we are producing 1000 units, but now we are requiring to add 500 more units. So here we have evaluated that 500 more units is being required in the market. Identify alternatives means whether you have got alternative way to give the market that is specific 500 product or you have to produce that in a specific unit. Then conduct financial analysis means what is the cost of increasing that specific 500 units. You are producing 1000 units, that is different, but now you require 500 more units. So here you have to conduct a financial analysis that what is the cost required for a company to produce that. Then assess key quality issues means here you have to assess that the quality of the product should be standardized. You should not play with the quality of the product. Means whatever the quality standards, you have to adopt that quality standards. Select best alternatives. Means there are certain alternatives I have told you that whether you are going to get the product from outsourcing and using it by a company tag or you are going to produce that specific product. So here, on the basis of financial analysis, you can take a decision. Then implement the alternative choices. Means whatever decision on the basis of the financial situations and the decision making process, the best alternative has been selected and it should be implemented. And after implementation, the last step comes into action. That is, you have to monitor the result that this is being implemented and whether it is giving the fulfilled result which is being desired by the organization, by the management or not. Now, determination of capacity requirement. Now, how you can say that this is what we required in the capacity? The first one is the facilities. Facilities is what? The location, the plant layout, the system you have got. So all these facilities must be streamlined in a proper manner. Then production and services factor. the product and services you are going to provide in the market. It should be matched with the proper standard. So a standard process should be adopted, a standard services should be given to the customers. So here, this is the second requirement for the capacity requirement. That the third one is the process factor. What is the process layout you have done? If you have gone through a specific cricket team, by selecting a specific cricket team, we have to see the place at which the match is going to be done. The pitches which is being there, as you have seen that in the countries where the fast bowler is being held by the environment, we used to take the fast bowlers, while in the specific countries like India, Pakistan, subcontinent, spinners are being taken. So here process is very important. What type of process is being required for the company to produce that specific product? Then human factors. As you all know that there are the four qualities which is being required, that is known as KSAO levels. K means skill, knowledge, S means skill, O means other characteristics, means you have to have a person who holds the proper knowledge and the skill about the job to be performed. So as much skill or knowledge he has about the job, automatically these factors are going to improve the capacity. Then operational factors. Now you have got raw material, you have made the process, you have got the facility, you know the product, you know the services. Now you have to operate it, you have to functionalize this. So this is very important function, that how you are going to operate it for the customer or the people who are going to take that service. Then supply chain factor. It is the most important factor, because all these factors are somewhere dependent on this factor, because this is the factor which is taking the final product to the market and giving that specific product at the right time when the customer required that product. Now, importance of capacity decisions. As I have told you, taking the best decision is very important for a manager, and he has to select the best alternatives. So here, these are the points which is being required. The first one is impacts ability to meet future demand. Means whatever capacity you are holding, it should have a proper ability to meet the future demand. As I have told you, we are producing the 1,000 unit, but in future required 1,500 units. So you have to add that 500 units in a specific time, so that whenever the market requires the 1,500 units, you can supply that specific unit. Then affects operating cost. If you are producing 1,000 unit and extra 500 required units required specific cost. So operating cost is very important for a manager, that how a manager can reduce the operating cost so that he can earn more and more profit. Major determinants of initial cost. The raw material, from where you are getting the raw material, the less the amount you can give on the raw material, the more profit you can get. So the initial cost is very major determinant in the capacity. Involves long-term commitment. Means whatever decision you are making, it should be dependent on the long-term commitment. Means long-term strategies we are going to follow. Means whatever decisions we are making, whatever laws, policies we are going to frame, it should be kept in mind for the long run, that is 5 to 10 years for the company to see into the future. Then affects competitiveness. As you all know that whatever product you are making, unless and until you have got the monopoly of that product in the market, you must have got specific competitors. So these competitors are time and again innovating their product. So as well as the innovation which has been taken in the specific product, you as a production manager also have to implement that innovation in your product. Because if you are taking all the new innovations in your product, the product will be user friendly and will be demanded in the market, because it is being using all the new technologies which are being there on the specific time. So here The competitiveness means the competitors and their product, your product comparison being made, and their product must have all the qualities which the competitor product has got. Effects ease of management means ease of doing business is very important. The process, the persons, the product, it should be very easily defined and must be understood by each and everyone. The simply it has been defined, the simply the person understand, and the work has been done in a very easy manner. So here capacity is all about easy doing business. How much you can ease of doing business, it is very important. Now globalization adds complexity. As you all know that now the world has been globalized village. We are living in a global village. Means whatever product is launching in America, Japan, China, you can see it by the help of internet. And as a person sitting in India, you also require that specific product. So here, on the basis of the globalization, we can see the product and we can make innovation in our product. So for increasing the capacity of specific things, the globalization or the new technologies in the whole world can be taken into consideration. So these impact long-range planning means if you are doing all these things automatically, the long-term planning can be easily made because your capacity decisions is somewhere or the other affects your short-term, medium-term as well as long-term. Because the long-term planning is all about the composite of short-term and medium-term planning. So these are very important for the capacity decision. As a manager of production manager, you have to go with all these points and you have to implement. So capacity is all about holding, storing and accommodating your things. How much a manager is going to give its input for the betterment of the organization and for the betterment of the production of a product. So capacity is all about doing your best for the best of the organization. So somewhere or the other, it is all about giving or using the optimum utilization of the resources. I think you have understood. Thank you.